Life as a Nova Scotia farmer. I gotta admit, it doesn't get much better than this. Acres upon acres of beautiful, fertile land teeming with rich biodiversity. I'm one lucky farmer. But recently, I've noticed that some modern farming practices are actually endangering the plants and animals living on my farm. Take, for example, the bobolink. This little creature likes to nest on open grasslands, and too often, my hay fields. And what happens when I cut my hay? Well, we can just leave that to your imagination. Fortunately, after talking to my agricultural association, we worked on a simple solution: modify my hay harvest. By pushing back my haying season by just a week and a half, the survival rate of bobolinks, short-eared owls, and meadowlarks, all of which are species at risk, can improve by 20%. With these birds around, pesky insects won't stand a chance. Apparently, the wood turtles are affected by mowing as well, as they too like to wander on open fields. So instead of giving them a haircut that's a little too close for comfort, I can just raise my mower blades. No haircut equals one happy turtle. Me personally? Well, this year I'm going to change my mowing patterns. And for the benefit of the critters, I'll use flushing bars to scare the bejesus out of these animals and chase them out of my fields before the mower gets them. So there you have it. Some minor changes in how we do things around here can go a long way in protecting our biodiversity.